Good morning. I'm presenting my paper on changes in intraocular pressure following phacoemulsification in angle closure patients. Primary angle closure glaucoma is estimated to affect 15 million people worldwide and is responsible for half of all glaucoma blindness. Prevalence of occlutable angle in Asia is 10.2%. A lens-induced mechanism in the development of angle closure glaucoma has been suggested. A thick crystalline lens might lead to angle closure through reduction of anterior chamber depth and narrowing of the angle. Phacoemulsification has shown to reduce the intraocular pressure and increase the anterior chamber depth, so it is effective in cases of angle closure. Primary objective of my study was to study the changes in intraocular pressure in patients with primary angle closure after phacoemulsification surgery, and there were other secondary objectives. All the patients included in the study underwent history taking examination including UCVA, BCVA, slit lamp biomicroscopic examination, fundus examination, IOP measurement using Goldman apprenation tonometry and gonioscopy. A standard phacoemulsification procedure was followed. All the patients aged 50 to 80 years with an IOP of more than 22 or two or more occasions with angle closure on gonioscopy were included, willing to provide a written informed consent, willing for a follow-up for a minimum of 3 months. All the patients with a history of prior ocular surgery, prior ocular trauma, diabetic patients, and occurrence of intraoperative complications were excluded from the study. 120 eyes of 100 patients completed the study with a mean follow-up of 3 months. There were 37.14% males, 43.80 females, out of which 5 had a primary angle closure glaucoma, 37 patients had primary angle closure suspects, and 63 patients were primary angle closure. Most of the patients included in my study were hyperopic and had an axial length between 21.1 to 23 millimeter. Only 6% had a lens thickness of less than 4.1 mm, while 94% had a lens thickness of more than 4.1. Nearly 50% of the patients had anterior chamber depth between 2 to 3 mm. The anterior chamber depth preoperatively was 2 to 2.99, while postoperatively it was more than 4 mm in most of the patients. Most of the angles were open postoperatively. The preoperative intraocular pressure was 20 to 24, and postoperatively it decreased to less than 20. The change in intraocular pressure following phacoemulsification was more than 5 mm in most of the patients. Postoperatively, the requirement of medications was only in 10% of the eyes. This is my comparison with the other studies. Conclusion, based on the available data, it seems reasonable to state that for patients with primary angle closure, phacoemulsification alone results in a modest decrease in IOP. Phacoemulsification eliminates the pupillary block, widens the angle to lessen the angle crowding, thus reducing the iridotrabecular proximity, and is the only treatment alternative that reduces, if not corrects, the responsible anatomical predisposition to angle closure. Thank you.